They waited. And I probably have another one. They say there's a young woman, a young racist in Atlanta. Say racist. And they say, I guess, they say that she was after a certain gang and she ended up having an affair with the head of the gang or a gang member. And this is a person that wants to indict me. She's got a lot of problems, but she wants to indict me to try and run for some other office. What's going on in this country is, and by the way, wants to indict me for a perfect phone call. This was even better than my perfect call with Ukraine.
Okay, I don't care so much about the stupid BS about the perfect call or him like going off on his nobody's ever seen it and then losing track of his own thought process. Now let's focus there on the fact that the former president of the United States is claiming 100% baselessly that the district attorney, Fani Willis, which is looking into him in Fulton County, and we expect indictments to come within the next week, had some sort of illicit affair with a gang member that she was investigating. If that seems wild, if that seems like, wait, wouldn't we have heard something about that? Yeah, no, your instincts are right. It's based on nothing. In fact, this isn't even the first time he's done it. It's just the first time that we've actually heard about it. Last week, he posted a video on Truth Social featuring a Rolling Stone headline about Miss Willis defending rapper YSL Mondo back in 2019. And he falsely claimed that she got caught hiding a relationship with a gang member she was prosecuting. There is no suggestion or evidence that she had any romantic relationships with the rapper, who described, quote, mother to son type of talks with her, according to Rolling Stone. She is married, she has two children. She is also expected to soon indict him for trying to overturn the results of the election. So if you were trying to put together a full list of the evidence with which he has crafted this argument that she had an affair with a rapper, it's that she's about to indict him. But he's not gonna allow him to, like, he is the former president of the United States. And I know that I'm an absolute moron to have any standards whatsoever. We should be totally comfortable with what he just did. It should be so normalized that nobody should have a problem with it. But it does seem, it seems insane even for America 2023. Jessica, what do you make of it?
It really does. It's especially insane when you consider Fani Willis's family. The people who came before her were involved with the Black Panther Party. And she lived in the United States long enough to become a district attorney in Fulton County. That's a pretty big deal. For Donald Trump to say that she's racist and then to call YSL a gang member simply because he's a rapper and he's Black, but he's calling Fani Willis racist, really, Donald Trump? To say something so explicitly racist and then accuse her of being racist is absolutely insane. It doesn't make any sense. Let's also just unpack the mother-son relationship. Would you want a defense attorney or a DA to kind of tell the young people who get in trouble, hey, like maybe reconsider this kind of life, maybe reconsider the behavior that got you caught up in the law? That sounds like a legal system I would like to have, where the defense attorneys and prosecutors care enough to have those conversations with people that are either their clients or someone that they have to prosecute on behalf of the state. That sounds like a pretty good situation for our justice system, better than business as usual. And so everything he says there is absurd. The way he goes into perfect phone call and trying to defend himself is absolutely ridiculous, because there's so much documented information to the contrary. And what he does there is he knows that his viewers and fans are not gonna look for that evidence or listen to it. They're like, oh, he says it's a perfect phone call? I guess he's not a criminal.
Yep. Yeah, like again, it's always a perfect phone call. It's always a hoax. I've given up on trying to get people to see past his absolutely buffoonish evasions from culpability for the things that he's done. And yeah, I agree with you about, you know, it's so weird that he would have a problem with this sort of strategy for a DA. Of course, he just wants, you know, it's a criminal. Just lock him up. Don't consider them. And especially, oh my God, if it's a Black criminal, then forget about it. By the way, this morning I saw Greg Gutfeld had said that 98% of accusations of racism are false. And I believe that we found the 2% that he would accept. It is Donald Trump calling every Black woman he's ever interacted with a racist. Why are they a racist? It's they're Black women. That's it. That's all it is. That's all it takes. He's not even making the case for why she's a racist. Did you notice that? He's not saying she said this mean thing about me, so that means that she's a racist against white people. Well, that would be bigotry, of course, and they can accept that that makes you racist against white people. It's totally irrelevant when people do it against people of color, but he's not even doing that. She just is black, that's it, end of story. And that's you know, unconvincing to people who don't pre-agree with him on that, but he knows his base and he knows what they think about people like Fani Willis and how ready they are to believe that sort of thing. And there's the racism, but then there's also the anyone he doesn't like, particularly women of color, you don't need to pay attention to anything they say, because if you consider the possibility that they're sluts, that's what he does with all of them. That's how they attacked Harris, that's how they're attacking her. It's just always there's something suspicious in their background sexually, so you shouldn't have to pay attention to them. I will ask a hypothetical. Let's say she did. Let's say she had that affair. Does that mean he didn't try to overthrow the results of the 2020 election? What possible bearing does that have on literally anything? And if you're automatically guilty of, if you're automatically guilty of everything because you had an affair, well, Donald Trump, I would point you to your past and the very well-documented affairs that you've engaged in. Of course, you're a dude, so it's not a problem. Let's remember that. Sorry, what were you gonna say?
I think I have some insight into what's going on here. He calls it a romantic relationship, right, John? He calls this thing that was just a parent-child conversation a romantic relationship. When you consider how he talks about Ivanka, maybe a parent-child relationship is romantic in his eyes.
Yeah, for us, it would seem to be ruling that out. For him, it's just the added special something to the romance. Absolutely gross, you're the worst. Anyway, we're gonna add this lie about her to the list, which as of when he'd ended his presidency, the Washington Post had cataloged 30,000 false or misleading statements, which is truly amazing. I mean, honestly, I don't know how much higher that is than any president, but it just objectively seems like a lot. And as I said when I intro this, bear in mind, they are expected to seek election charges in Fulton County sometime in the next week, so prepare for that.
For more political news breakdowns, interviews, stories of activism, and me trying my hardest to care about the occasional big celebrity news story, subscribe to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/thedamagereport. And you can ring the bell wherever it is so you don't miss anything.